Good evening, and welcome to the Church of St. Peter's. Please join us in singing our opening song, number 68. Lift up your heads, ye mighty gates, number 68.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
We're sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who see how your people faithfully await the feast of the Lord's Nativity, enable us, we pray, to attain the joys of so great a salvation and to celebrate them always with solemn worship and glad rejoicing. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zephaniah. Shout for joy, O daughter Zion. Sing joyfully, O Israel. Be glad and exult with all your heart, O daughter Jerusalem. The Lord has removed the judgment against you. He has turned away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You have no further misfortune to fear. On that day, it shall be said to Jerusalem, "Fear not, O Zion, be not discouraged. The Lord, your God, is in your midst, a mighty Savior. He will rejoice over you with gladness and renew you in his love. He will sing joyfully because of you, as one sings at festivals." The word of the Lord.
Right. confident and unafraid. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. With joy you will draw water at the fountain of salvation. Cry out with joy and gladness, for among you is the great and holy one of Israel. Give thanks to the Lord, acclaim his name. Among the nations, make known his deeds. Proclaim how exalted is his name.
Cry out with joy and gladness, for among you is the great and holy one of Israel.
Sing praise to the Lord for his glorious achievement. Let this be known throughout all the earth. Shout with exultation, O city of Zion, for your grandeur midst is the Holy One of Israel.
Cry out with joy and gladness, for among you is the great and holy one of Israel.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice in the Lord always. I shall say it again, rejoice. Your kindness should be known to all. The Lord is near. Have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
With you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The crowds asked John the Baptist, "What should we do?" He said to them in reply, "Whoever has two cloaks should share with the person who has none, and whoever has food should do likewise." Even tax collectors came to be baptized, and they said to him, "Teacher, what should we do?" He answered them, Stop collecting more than what is prescribed. Soldiers also ask him, and what is it that we should do? He told them, do not practice extortion, do not falsely accuse anyone, and be satisfied with your wages. Now the people were filled with expectation, and all were asking in their hearts whether John might be the Christ. John answered them all, saying, I am baptizing you with water, but one mightier than I is coming. I am not worthy to loosen the thongs of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fan is in his hand to clear the threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his barn. But the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire. Exhorting them in many other ways, he preached good news to the people. The Gospel of the Lord.
Third Sunday of Advent, called Gaudete, brings us color that that is used only twice in a year. We use it in today, Gaudete Sunday, and fourth Sunday of Lent, called Letare. But this also means that we are just getting closer to celebrating Christmas. Luke's gospel brings us important role of John the Baptist. Crowd of people come to John to be baptized. These people are not motivated only by curiosity, rather they are moved by John's preaching and his very strict and ascetic life. The baptism they receive is a sign of their profound transformation. This is also showed by the question they ask John, like, what should we do? This question is asked by a different type of people from a different category, social position, including groups that are considered to be on the margins of society. John the Baptist does not suggest a different path. He does not call people to leave their professions, families, go to a desert and live his lifestyle or imitate his life in any kind of way. He does not encourage soldiers to become pacifist or tax collectors, officials, to quit their jobs. Everyone must stay where they are, but live differently. Differently means to be guided by justice and mercy. John gives advice to people who ask him about the way of salvation, about how to get out of a situation of unbelief and immorality and get close to God. They must become a good tree to bring and bear fruit worthy of conversion. It is no longer enough to refer to tradition, to Abraham or law, because the deeds of many Abraham's descendants are just similar to the deeds of the Gentiles who do not know God. It will soon be shown that the Gentiles will become children of God without being even Israelites. John calls to conversion of heart. It is a call that change the source of being. Conversion is it's not about changing environment or workplace. It's not about changing others. It is about honest and internal transformation. Usually, sin and problems are not about people's profession, like tax collectors, but in the way in which it is practiced. Conversion is not also about any extraordinary, spectacular gestures or external visible changes. Fidelity, faithfulness, and dedication counts in a daily life when we do small steps day by day in our conversion. So the transformation of a human heart does not necessarily concern external things and situations. Real transformation touch the inside, the heart, and it starts with us. But very often things goes around. I mean, we want to change the world once we realize it's impossible or really hard. There's attempt to change people who are around us, and when it also won't work, it is finally easy to come to a conclusion that it is I am who can be changed, that we should start from our own person. By changing our own way of thinking, speaking, attitude, we are changing ourselves, people around us, and automatically world that is around us. It doesn't have to be a big change, rather constant daily work on the small things. That's how conversion works. And John calls people to conversion because he knows that God is coming to this world. Someone who is totally from high, from above, comes down to us who are lowly creatures. And we want to be close to God. We want to get close to him. Like Jesus Christ, even when he is his human form, human incarnation, he's still more human than we are. By changing and changing our lives, by transformation and conversion, we becoming more human. We becoming like he is. The person of John the Baptist as a teacher and witness might be for us a model of Christian life. But it's more his attitude and his heart. He changed his life completely. He was a son of the priest. He's supposed to be follow the steps of his father. But he decided to go outside to live the life totally different. His teaching to sinners is a rebuke and powerful exhortation to conversion. The effectiveness of this preaching depends on the openness of people's hearts. The question, what shall we do? It's more like a modern question, no, how? And it includes the humble search for a guidance on how to live in order to be close to God. John the Baptist's answer are clear and specific. It requires a radical cutoff from sin and break with everything that enslaves us. That is a radical conversion, and to the same conversion, Jesus will be calling other people. But this time, it won't be the words of man, it won't be the words of prophet, but God himself will be calling to do that. So let us all give ourselves some time that we have left before Christmas to do that preparation, to prepare ourselves for God's coming, to become more human like he is.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages. God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consummated, invisible, 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 invisible. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord of the Church, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who is the Father and the Son, is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The loving Father, let us present our petitions and prayers.
the church in her mission to announce the good news. May God's light illuminate her path. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who hold public office, may the Holy Spirit create in them a heart that works to protect the dignity and sanctity of all life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer from fear or anxiety, may God comfort them with his healing presence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, as we continue our Advent journey, may the Holy Spirit bring us to a renewed awareness of God's presence in our lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, that they may know the glory and the splendor of heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our special intentions, especially for the intention of this Mass, Richard Lauer, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and ever-loving God, we humbly pray that you bless these petitions, announcing them in accordance with your holy will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our preparation of the gifts hymn is number 56, Christ Circle Round Us, number 56.
pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the sacrifice of our worship, Lord, we pray, be offered to you unceasingly to complete what was begun in sacred mystery and powerfully accomplish for us your saving work. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for the day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Gives you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, he gave life to all things and made them holy, and you never ceased to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will it to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we relied for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Thomas John, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at the passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Few announcements this evening. Cookies and freshly baked cinnamon rolls are available downstairs in the cafeteria after Mass. Please come down and support the important work of the Social Concerns Committee. Also, make sure to turn in your giving gift this weekend. They will be picked up on Monday morning. And finally, we have 2022 calendars in the narthex. Please take one. If you know someone in a nursing home, please take one for them too.
Let us pray. We implore your mercy, Lord, that this divine sustenance may cleanse us of our faults and prepare us for the coming feasts. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying our Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing hymn is number 575, Let Heaven Rejoice, number 575.
Sound the trumpet into the night.